Good day, everyone, and welcome to Honeywell's SmartView SVS, the latest evolution in business aviation safety of flight webinar. I'm Dan Stockfish, Senior Strategic Sales Manager for Honeywell, and along with me today is Robert Ehrlich, one of our senior lead test pilots. We are privileged to be your webinar host for today. We would like to begin by showing you two of our most recent SVS approach videos. The first video is an approach into Hong Kong using Gulfstream's SVPFD 2.0 SVS. And the second video you'll see is a black hole approach into Medford, Oregon, using Dassault's EZ2 SVS.
Approaching 1-4.
Lights coming off.
Thank you.
500.
Ground contact. Lights visible. Continue.
200.
I have the runway. Going around.
Roger. Flaps are coming through. Two. Gears coming up.
Thank you. Going to.
Metro Davis, Quebec, current at the Medford Airport. Wind is variable at 4, visibility 1/2, runway 14 RVR, 2,400, fog, Ceiling indefinite 200, temperature 9er, dew point 9er, altimeter 3009er.
We are back, and we trust that you enjoyed the two videos. The videos are posted on Honeywell's YouTube site, and we will provide you with the link information later in the presentation. Our agenda today will take us through a quick look at SmartView's program status, a top-level overview of symbology and features, and a review of the key system benefits. We will then focus on the need for what we are calling a paradigm shift in the way avionics safety enhancements are perceived. We will do this by discussing some of the past and more recent safety trends of the automobile and aircraft industries. We will discuss how safety trends and new products supporting the automobile industry seem to go unchallenged and are readily accepted compared with those new safety discoveries for the aircraft industry, which are often met with resistance and struggle to get their due credit for the true value they offer. We will walk through two separate yet convincing studies testifying to SmartView's value proposition, and then briefly discuss an accident scenario that SmartView's capabilities certainly could have helped to avert. We will also show you how to walk a company decision maker through an executive summary of SmartView's value proposition. I will then turn the presentation over to Robert, who will share a few practical applications of how our Honeywell flight crews use SmartView. Not to end there, Robert will conclude our webinar by giving you a little inside look at where we are headed with SmartView's evolution. SmartView's first generation system, version 1.0, was first certified on Gulfstream's Plainview aircraft back in January of 2008. Since then, Honeywell and Gulfstream have certified the latest SmartView configuration, version 2.0, which Gulfstream has named SVPFD 2.0. More than half of all the Plainview aircraft are equipped with either SVPFD 1.0 or 2.0, and Gulfstream believes so strongly in the value of SmartView that they have made it standard on their brand new G650. Dassault certified SmartView's latest generation system on the Falcon 900 Easy in May of 2011. SmartView is an Easy 2 option of which more than 50% of the fleet has already selected. There has been good news coming out of China recently with regards to improvements being made to the WGS-84 runway data. So much so that earlier this year, Jeppesen changed China's WGS-84 status on its website from non-compliant to compliant. However, we realize that there is still a lot that needs to happen before they can be deemed fully compliant for all runways. But given the past history of China's reluctance to release this information, we view this as a very positive step moving in the right direction. There are three key building blocks of technology that make up SmartView: the color graphics from the heads down display, the accuracy and symbology from the heads up display, and Honeywell's own proven EGPWS terrain database, which is rapidly approaching a billion flight hours. Whenever I present this slide to a live audience, I rarely can move on without at least one person stopping me and asking about our heads up versus heads down philosophy. So since you don't have the opportunity to stop me here, let me just take a moment to share our response with you. First of all, Honeywell is not against HUDs, and we certainly aren't proposing to replace them. We believe the heads down, or SVPFD, is complementary to the HUD, and both play significant roles as key flight guidance tools for the pilot. The HUD provides some great enhancements to energy and path monitoring that aren't available without it. We also like the HUD's continuity of symbology from head down to head out in the transition from instrument to visual. With the HUD symbology on the SVPFD, we get the same benefit, but with full-time registration to the terrain and runway. We also like that the SVPFD has over 1 million colors, which makes it so much easier to interpret all the weather conditions. Finally, the flight path marker and runway symbology provided both on the SVPFD and HUD provide great visual anchor points to transition from the head down to head up frame of reference. SVS is a simple, intuitive display which decreases pilot workload and notably improves overall flight safety by integrating terrain, major obstacles, and runway information with existing PFD data to present a day VMC world which dramatically improves nighttime and IMC situational awareness. The constant information scan to build a mental picture of the outside environment is eliminated, mentally freeing up the pilot to focus on other tasks that may have been previously overlooked. A look at Gulfstream's standard PlainView primary flight display and PlainView's SVPFD 2.0. And SO's standard easy primary flight display, the EZ2 baseline primary flight display, and the EZ2 primary flight display with SVS. The first thing to remember about flying with SmartView is that it's always a sunny and clear day on the PFD. Certainly, not all the symbology displayed on SVS is unique to the feature. However, there are many prominent situational awareness cues that are. These include conformal to the ground range rings positioned at 3, 5, 10, 20, and 30 nautical miles from the aircraft, grid lines depicting an approximate north-south, east-west grid spaced at 0.4 nautical mile distances along both axes, all obstacles 1,500 feet and higher, a highlighted runway symbol, and its associated extended center line. Additionally, SVS makes several existing control inputs much more compelling by precisely displaying them over top of the outside world. Some great examples of these include the zero pitch reference or horizon line, which provides pilots with an instantaneous view of terrain and obstacles above and below the aircraft's flight path, and the flight path marker displaying where the aircraft is actually headed. In this case, it's headed way short of the runway. Several enhancements were made to SmartView's original version 1.0, including significant graphical enrichments made to the runway detailing. Several new features were also added to version 2.0, including the range rings, grid lines, runway outline, and extended center line. Enhanced SVS also incorporated a terrain display within the HSI on the SVPFD, providing a top-down view similar to Honeywell's Interactive Navigation, or iNav, and it also hosts the display for EGPWS terrain alerts. SmartView is a tactical decision-making tool that helps crews make necessary short-term decisions during flight. It complements iNav, used in Primus Epic integrated avionics systems like those standard on Gulfstream PlainView and SO Easy aircraft. SmartView also helps pilots by backing up decision links in the accident chain even further, providing a new level of safety. It is a proven ground proximity tool, preventing decisions leading toward controlled flight in terrain, and because SmartView is easily interpreted, it provides the crew with an increased margin of safety that helps balance and even reduce workload. It is no accident that SmartView's list of significant benefits are all related to enhancing safety. This was our primary design goal from the start for SmartView, and we believe we have nailed it. That being said, introducing a new safety enhancement to the aviation marketplace has and continues to have its challenges. This is almost exclusively due to the current negative perception, which most new safety devices must overcome. That perception is this: if someone is telling us that we need some new safety device that would help us to be safer, What we often hear is what that statement implies, which is we are unsafe now. Bringing this closer to our discussion today, if a chief pilot or any other key influencer within a flight department presents an opportunity to his or her owner to purchase a system whose key value to their company is enhanced flight safety, 99 times out of 100, the only thing that gets heard is that we are flying unsafe. Unfortunately, this could not be further from the truth. And it is exactly why we are trying to make the attempt here to compare the safety evolution of the automobile industry with that of the aviation industry. The reason for this is that the automotive industry has been extremely successful at shifting the perception of safety-related products in the minds of its customers from one of we are unsafe to one of we will be safer with this new and next evolution. It is truly an evolution of safety. It is not about being unsafe, but being safer. This is what we mean when we say paradigm shift in perception. Let's look quickly at the two industries and see how they have grown safer with each evolution. The 1930s to the 50s saw a headlight that turned with the steering wheel, seat belts, safety glass, disc brakes, turn signals, padded dashboard, crumple zones, bumper shocks, and even a three-point lap and shoulder belt. The 60s through the 80s brought about the collapsible steering column, additional padding on the front instrument panel, elimination of protruding knobs and controls in the passenger compartment, airbags, and a rear center third brake light, which was ultimately mandated in North America. Then beginning in the 90s, we were introduced to the side impact protection system, brake assist, automotive night vision, backup cameras, adaptive cruise control, lane departure warning, electronic stability control, and driver alertness detection system, all in the name of safety. And in a similar fashion, avionics has evolved. Beginning in 1910 through the 60s, we have Elmer Sperry's gyroscope, artificial horizon and gyro horizon, the first checklist, ILS, INS, integrated instrument panel, including flight director, HSI, and gyroson compass indicator, weather radar, auto throttles, and VORs. Then in the 70s and the 80s came the beacon collision avoidance system, GPWS, CAT-3A, HUD, FMS, moving map displays, and digital flight control systems. More recently, beginning in the 90s, we saw TCAS, enhanced GPWS, GPS, wind shear detection, fans, CPDLC, RVSM, 3D weather radar, synthetic vision, infrared, smart runway and smart landing, SBAS, and the combined vision system. We need to shift the paradigm and change the safety perception. Just so you don't get the idea that all the positives we have been sharing with you so far about SmartView's safety value driver is just all Honeywell speak, let's switch gears for a moment and share a couple of SVS studies that have been done without any Honeywell involvement. First, NASA and Gulfstream formed a team which actually won them an award back in 2005. NASA led the study using a G5 flying in and out of the terrain-challenged Reno Tahoe International Airport. Simply put, they wanted to know if SVS offered any help at all in limited visibility conditions. The result? Yes, it did, and significantly, by 150%. The second study was also conducted and led by NASA, but this time they wanted to know how SVS would perform against standard flight instrumentation in averting CFIT accidents. The test, they used 16 pilots. All of them had a terrain awareness system and a vertical situation display on the enhanced nav display, and 12 of the 16 pilots also had SVS. They let them get somewhat acclimated to another terrain challenged airport in Eagle, Colorado, by flying 21 approach and departure maneuvers in IMC conditions. On the 22nd and final run, they altered the flight guidance cues so the departure path flew them directly into the terrain. The result, all 12 pilots flying with SVS avoided the potential CFID event, and all four of the pilots without SVS had a CFID incident. NASA concluded that SVS will quite dramatically improve a pilot's ability to detect and avoid a CFID event. While on final approach to Houston William P. Hobby in thick fog, the aircraft struck a light pole located 1.5 miles short of runway 4 and crashed in a nearby marshy field. Both pilots and a flight attendant were killed. This was not a rookie crew. The captain had close to 19,000 total flight hours, 15,700 of which were as pilot in command. And the first officer had over 19,000 total flight hours, with 17,700 of those being logged as pilot in command. On November 2006, the NTSB determined that the probable cause of the crash was a flight crew's failure to adequately monitor and cross-check the flight instruments during the approach. Contributing to the accident was the flight crew's failure to select the ILS frequency in a timely manner, most likely mistaking the fast-slow indicator for the glide slope indicator throughout the approach sequence, and to adhere to approved company approach procedures, including the stabilized approach criteria. Had SVS been available for this aircraft type, and had it been installed, and if the flight crew had it turned on, they would have certainly had one more powerful and proven avionics safety enhancement they could have used to prevent this tragedy from happening. Up to this point, you have seen how the SmartView synthetic vision system lays out critical flight information in a composite pilot flight display screen with easy to interpret and consistent symbology and coloring schemes. We have demonstrated the pilot's increased situational awareness with this synthetic vision flight display by showing how location, navigation, terrain, and air traffic obstacles, movement and trend data, as well as lead-in depictions of the airport environment and approach path in the previous slides. As we have just discussed, we see that a large portion of aviation mishaps and accidents have resulted from the loss of or degraded pilot situational awareness. It is important to understand that pilot displayed synthetic vision is a feature that will aid pilots with increasing their situational awareness, which becomes more and more a part of the potential accident chain as the dynamic pilot workload approaches task saturation. SmartView is the one system immediately capable of making your next flight safer than ever before. The slide is included in the presentation for the sole purpose of being used as a briefing slide for aviation directors, aircraft management company directors, chief pilots, maintenance directors, certified aircraft managers, or any other key personnel within a flight department who have a significant vote in making the SVS decision, but not necessarily the final vote. We developed this slide to be a short, comprehensive, get-to-the-point tool to help you articulate the true value of SmartView SVS, which we have just spent the past 20 minutes or so documenting. It is fully intended to be used in conjunction with one of the two new approach videos we showed during the beginning of this webinar. Both videos are available on Honeywell's YouTube site. Here's a quick look at some of the resources we use for the material in this presentation for those of you wishing to dive a little deeper into some of the study data we presented. With that, I will now turn the remainder of our time together over to Robert Ehrlich.
Thanks, Dan. We've seen now the composite makeup of SmartView on the PFD, discussed its displays, functions, and how this increased situational awareness is considered a huge value for safety purposes. In the next few slides, I'd like to speak to not only the practical applications for approaches and departures, but also cover how SmartView will translate to lower minimums and what that means for the future of SVS-CVS-equipped aircraft and instrument approaches. As you may remember from your past experience flying under VFR conditions, visibility is not necessarily clear blue and 22, even while reported clear. In fact, you may have hazy conditions. I can remember flying in Los Angeles, for example, and making a VFR approach to Fullerton Airport where the weather was reported as greater than 3 miles with no ceilings. Yet I could not clearly see the runway until I was about a mile final due to the heavy smog conditions that day. Flying at night, a pilot's visibility is reduced by the lower ambient and even artificial lighting, such as poor runway lighting, or brighter peripheral lighting, such as from the city, can obscure the runway environment. Additionally, approaches and departures may have significant terrain nearby, which you may not have in your direct view. Combine synthetic vision with a colorized real image insert on the flight display, and the pilot's options and situational awareness have just increased again. CVS is a combined vision system which incorporates the images of an infrared camera into the center view of the synthetic display in order to enhance detail when needed. It is designed to toggle off and on so that the FLIR image would show at the pilot's control. Combined vision system, or CVS, is a combination of enhanced vision systems, or EVS, and SVS technology. The EVS and SVS depictions are conformal with each other, meaning consistent, seamless symbology and color depictions. In an approach mode flight, CVS would follow a selective blending. As the aircraft nears the runway, the picture gradually and smoothly transitions from synthetic to enhanced vision. As this slide demonstrates, while the pilot sees the runway with natural vision on the left, a glance at the flight display shown on the right has depicted the end of the runway, as well as the rising terrain to the left of the departure path, as well as the symbology and color coding, providing the pilot with additional situational awareness to confirm on path and on course. Enhanced Flight Vision Systems, or EFVS, combines EVS and a HUD, so you can see the topography as well as flight information. EFVS is an electronic means to provide a display of the forward external scene topography using enhanced vision systems. EASA uses the term Enhanced Vision Systems, or EVS. Because this technology is approved today in terms of lower approach minimums, regulatory agencies have defined a set of requirements in addition to that of having information and visual depictions displayed on a HUD. At a minimum, the following will be depicted: airspeed and vertical speed, attitude, heading, and altitude, command guidance, path deviation indications, flight path vector, and flight path angle reference cue. Additionally, all symbology and images must be aligned and scaled to the external view. Authorization to use EFVS to descend below the decision height or minimum decision altitude down to 100 feet is available today. To descend lower, you must see the runway or the runway environment with natural vision. The FAA now refers to the current authorization as EFVS-1. You can see the structure and effective EFVS lower segment in the diagram. There is a proposed rule that will allow descent to the runway using EFVS with visibility at least at RVR of 1,000 feet. It would not be necessary to see the runway with natural vision in this case to continue the approach. This would be called EFVS-2. Here, you can see how the structure of EFVS-2 will fit with EFVS-1. Equipage and training for EFVS-2 will be more stringent. Another lower approach proposition in the works is SVLM, or synthetic vision for lower minimums. SVLM combines synthetic vision and position monitors that are independent of the primary to ensure the aircraft is where it thinks it is. It monitors runway data integrity, nav position, altitude, and flight path steering error. If the monitors don't agree, the pilot will get a warning to abandon the approach. The objective is to get CAT-2 minimums with RVR of 1,400 feet and a decision height of 150 feet. Additional display features will provide increased situational awareness and allow pilots to see virtual renditions of objects like the PAPI or where the inner marker is located. In closing, you have seen an in-depth description and demonstration of the features of SmartView. Dan described a very clear link between how SmartView can increase a pilot's situational awareness in the most adverse environments and increasing pilot workload situations. This increased situational awareness has a direct link to increased safety for crews, as well as a very real potential for reducing incidents, as has been shown in this presentation with a review of prior cases. I followed by demonstrating not only how SVS increases pilot situational awareness in both VFR and IFR environments, but also how it relates to lower approach minimums. Finally, you have seen how this technology pushes forward and regulatory agencies begin looking at plans to implement further advancements into even lower approach minimums. SmartView offers a multitude of advantages that are not only immediately realized in the flight environment, but also prepares crews and platforms for future improvements and lower approach minimums. That concludes our presentation. Please feel free to contact Flight Technical Services with any questions or concerns about implementing this technology.